got a few things still here. Hey, that's enough. Okay, I got one thing to do with this mask before I give it to the Skull Kid. Speaking of which, no, I don't have Cyrus on yet, so I gotta go all the way through the woods anyway. This is a bit cheating, having a reticle. I messed up. I hate that this is on a joystick. Leave me alone, owl. There's the hole. I don't remember when I'm supposed to play here. If I'm supposed to play anything. Oh yeah, I don't know where it's on. Duh. Guess I'll just do that after I finish the mask quiz. Yeah, I knew that was gonna happen. I'm waiting for you, my dude. many skultulas do I have so far? Only four? Oh my god. I gotta get those numbers up. Oh my dark bullet. Don't care about getting hit here. Yes, there was a fairy fountain. Need that bottle for bugs. Oh, that should unlock the ugly mask that the kid thinks looks like Dante. Which one is the twins' house? Is it this one? No. I wonder how this will look with the randomizer. Single bed. I mean, it's this one. No, this is Mayo's house. That gold skull too is probably an adult check. I have the check tracker for the randomizer and item tracker up for some reason, even though I'm just playing vanilla through the game. And the reason there is different music playing in the background other than Legend of Zelda music is because I keep getting copyright flags for the game's music.
Ow. Ow. Ow.
remember if I got the one in this. No. I wouldn't have gotten any gold skulls other than. The ones inside the deck of tree. That is not what I meant to do. I already talked to the guy on the roof, I think. I can't remember though, because it was a few days ago when I did this, so. I should really just look at the check tracker. Above Impa's house, so. Whoa, why didn't that work? I know I can't complete the mask quest before I do Jabu Jabu, because the mailman won't be out in Hyrule Field before then. Ah, the funny thing about that is I only wanted to complete the quest so I could get the bunny hood, so, like, I'm gonna be able to get to the bunny hood anyway. There's a gold skultula in here to collect. And money, since Skull Kid did not pay us enough for that mask. Thank you. Okay, so we can get our adult wallet now. Oh, he did pay me enough for the... I guess it's this one that I don't get enough for. Skull Kid gave me exact amount, first person overpaid. Oh, since we're right here. I may not end up doing optional things like bag upgrades and such, because they're just shooting gallery rewards. And you don't actually need any of the like upgraded ammos to beat the game. That being said, I will do the bomb chews to get the bomb chew. I think some of the shooting gallery rewards might be heart pieces, but I don't think so. I literally think they're just upgrades, if I remember correctly. I know I've done the entire game without doing them before. Where am I going? Graveyard. In 10 minutes, our life is going to be infinitely easier here, because I'm playing on the Harkinian mod, which means that the bunny hood is going to act like it does in Majora's Mask. Oh, I guess I did not remember that correctly at all. I honestly thought there was somebody that didn't pay me enough. Unless I just misread with the Skull Kid and he didn't pay me enough. Are you returning them? Thank you, money. I can hold money. I will hopefully be able to use the bunny hood as adult as well. I was like, doing the randomizer, I think. Unless that was the mix randomizer that I did that in. I can't remember. Some more money in our pockets. So we can hold it. Oh, Well, that was some money, at least. And it looks like the mod's holding up to keep the bunny hood on through transition. Fantastic. Alright, yes, we move much faster now. Gold Skultula is at Lon Lon Ranch. I should be able to get another heart before going up the mountain as well. Probably more I can do before going up the mountain, like a lot more. I'm just not thinking about it. Besides the stuff I'm purposely skipping, like the shooting gallery. Okay, I have been here already, so I have done these things. We're here for 3 gold skulltulas. Does this one appear as an adult? I can't get it without my boomerang anyway. We already grabbed the heart piece from here. I'm so bad with attacking and hurting myself from the attack, and I don't think I can reach the one over here because it's too high on the wall as well. Yes. Okay, so. Come back here after Jabu Jabu with the boomerang. Before becoming an adult to grab those. If I remember that. That's not likely at all. Okay, so now that we have the bunny hood also, it doesn't matter whether it's night or day out here, because as long as you're wearing the bunny hood, stall childs will not spawn. I thought I put my bottle up here. Bunny hood literally makes things infinitely faster. Get out of my face, Raru. Why are you an owl when I'm a child, but you appear in human, well, Hylian spirit form, whatever the fuck form you appear as when I'm an adult? Some weird shit. Alright, so there will be skulltulas we have to come back here for later with the boomerang as well. Piece number one. You can either do what I'm doing to get this art piece, or you can just fly over to that ledge to the left there, and then jump down here and climb the ladder. I was hoping there would be bugs under that. Oh well. Alright. We're gonna have to go all the way back there in a second. Wow, we spent the whole night running across there. That's kind of ridiculous. Oh my god, no, don't do that. Fishing. We're already here. I would love to lie and say I just edited that real quick, but like, for some reason it just auto-caught it. So the funny thing is, that actually wasn't the way I was gonna get the heart piece. We just ended up getting it a little bit quicker. There's another one in the Gerudo Valley that we're gonna go back for. Then we might make our way up the mountain. Ah! Get away from me, pee hats. I'm faster than you. Ass hat of a freaking chicken. Well, I'm gonna skip that gold skultula for now then. Oh my god. Okay, well at least I'm not gonna accidentally hit that button. Six hearts before ever going through that gate feels good. I usually don't collect the heart pieces around Hyrule until I'm an adult, at least, and defeated at least a Shadow Temple. I usually just go with the ones they give me at the end of each dungeon. I'm lazy like that. I will fully do Dudongo's Cavern on this stream as well. See, this is how OP that bunny hood is. It did not turn dark while we ran across from Lake Hylia. It would have definitely turned dark if we did not have a bunny hood on. That being said, if you're playing on the N64 or the 3DS version or whatever, the bunny hood does not make you go faster like it does in Majora's Mask. Simply because the Harkinian mod allows for it. There's other ways you can do the randomizers and stuff that will allow for it as well. It'll be an option in a lot of different randomizers. Well, I shouldn't say a lot of different randomizers. I've only tried three different randomizers for these games. This one just so happens to be my favorite. Because I can also play the vanilla. Oh yeah. Oh no, the song's just not playing because the music's off. Jam into this lo-fi track instead of Saria's song. It is a hot beat. I will put a link to the soundtrack that's playing in the background in the description of this video after the stream, as well as on the YouTube video when I post it. I don't know why I'm going through that so slow. Yes, let me pick your bone flowers. That my bunny hood's just gonna infinitely stay on. That makes me so happy. Nice, got the sign. We are destructive. Throwing them. Let's speedrun the Dudongo's Cavern!
Yeah.
Miss. Tells me the shield, but I don't think so. Deku stick. I mean, there's someone in the lobby that. I could make it so that my Deku sticks are invincible and always on fire, but like, that just seems like a little too much for a regular playthrough. That's a specific setting that this has for glitchless. Compass, I believe. Map. Wrong one. And there will be 40 rupees in this room. Thank you. I'm gonna lose health unless I might know it. That block looks so much smoother with this. I forget how OP Deku 6 can pull nuts can be. Deku 6 are always OP. They hit like a master sword. Now, anybody watching this knows exactly what they sell in Manila. There's only 3 scrubs in the entire game that actually sell things you're gonna want. But if you're doing a randomizer, it's good to know where all the scrubs are. Oh shit. I went back further than I thought I did. Thank you. I like that they didn't update that. Since I opened this, I do not remember what this is. It's a blue ruby. Here's where I end up losing all my health because of fucking flaming bats. There's another scrub through that door. I'm not going through it. Tells you nothing of importance. I have 2 hearts, I'm not restarting this. Heart? Oh, that'll work. That'll work. All right, Mr. Dudongo. Let's rumble. Easiest boss battle in the game. If I had used my Deku sticks, that would have gone faster. Bye bye, Mr. Dodongo King. It really wasn't hard to kill you. I don't know why the Gorons couldn't. They're not as good as they think they are. Dude, how did that not kill me? This kid seems to be tough enough not only to defeat something that the Gorons can't, but to, like, take a giant head pounding from a fucking beast of a thing that eats rocks. Almost done this monster, almost gonna have to bust open the alcohol. That'll be fun. Maybe if I get sauced up enough, I'll record Jabu Jabu's belly later. You need to go up there. Waste of health. I'm so glad I got the adult wallet, because there's going to be another 20 rupees right there. I mean, the game does kind of expect you to grab the adult's wallet at that point. The problem is, they don't give you any explanation as to the fact that there is an adult's wallet, or where to go for gold skultulas or any of that fun stuff. Just something you gotta kind of figure out. Figure out what the rewards are the first time you play through. We're in the bunny hood, and I have the fast climb, so I probably could have made it past all of them. Give me magic! If I can play the song right. Welcome, my dude. Thanks. It's not where you get magic. Was where I was headed next. Well, kind of. Got a heart piece to collect. I have a magic meter. Hey, take me with you. Oh, and it's nighttime. Can I get that gold skulltula as a kid? Well, I would assume not, because there's none there. There'll be another one in the Zoran River, at least one, that I can remember off the top of my head. But before that, we're gonna go get something from another fairy. Is it dense fire that she gives us this early? I don't think so. First health upgrade? Wow, it's been way too long since I played vanilla. Don't know why I ran all the way over here. Just gonna have to do that run again in 2 seconds. Okay. Thought it would have respawned me at that. I guess it doesn't. It's something fun as well. In case you didn't know about this. I guess it doesn't work in the Harkinian. In original Ocarina, you get 20 rupees for doing that. I wish the bunny hood just made you so fast that these guards couldn't catch you. That would be awesome. I do get Tins Fire this early. Now that's again provided that you actually come here and grab it. The game does guide you towards this one, and technically towards that last one, because they tell you to go to the top of the mountain, seek the Great Fairy, and then that Great Fairy tells you about the one in the Hyrule Castle area. But that being said, that's all the information you get on that. I get this one without a boomerang. Did I not put that in the right spot? I guess that's a storm one? Okay. Thought you could bomb your way in there. I guess I was wrong. But that's a fun way to get all your gold skultula tokens when you have a boomerang. Because you kill the gold skultula, you throw your boomerang at the token, and then jump backwards into the thing that takes you out of the grotto. You get the token, and the gold skultula will be back when you go down there again. Okay. We're in river time. Might as well buy a few beans while we're there as well. that's all I'm gonna buy for now. Yeah, we get to that from a different direction. I mean, I'm pretty sure that can only be done as an adult. Enough, buddy. Okay. We're gonna completely ignore you. And that's our third bottle. And now we get to listen to this guy go wink, wink, wink. Gets me every time. 3 fairy fountains in under 20 minutes. I will say this spell kind of sucks. It's really only useful, in my opinion, in one temple throughout this entire game, and that is the water temple. Funny enough, I am going to be ending here, but I'm going to put myself inside Jabba Jabba's belly, because, 6 o'clock here, I'm going to go make some dinner, and then possibly get a little saucy later, and then record inside Jabba Jabba's belly. So yeah, let's get in there. So much nicer. Holy crap. Okay, does this still work? Look at that. Look at that. I am mainly referring to the webbing on the door in the background and also the dangling uvula-like button. Yeah, just those. Also, all the buttons up in the top here hold my stuff, like, and the actual look of the items themselves. Just, I like how it cracks that deck you're not open. Yeah, this isn't even technically original graphics like this. This is still upgraded HD Harkinian graphics right here. So this isn't even what the original looks like. I wonder, actually. Two seconds here. Let's see if I can pull up what the original graphics look like side by side comparison. Oh god, both games are going over top of each other right now. Oops. So, yeah. I think this should be able to show you. Alright, so, not like the easiest to see, but like just the hood is much more crisp on the Harkinian here than it is in that original there. I will say though, the hearts look crisper in the original. But yeah, I can just see all the, like, grainy pixelation on the hood in the one that's going on Project 64 right now. Versus a smooth-edged hood on the Harkinian model. And then if I... click Harkinian here. And then even more of a difference there. End this so that I can go make something to eat. Thanks for watching.